Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making garlic mashed potatoes. And I want to show you what I'm starting with. I have russet potatoes about this size, and I use 6 of them. So I think it's about 2.5 pounds worth. So you can adjust as you need for whomever you're having. We're having this for Thanksgiving, and if you're having it for Thanksgiving, then just adjust to your crowd. Now, with these potatoes, I'm going to put garlic, so they'll have a nice garlicky flavor. I did a quick tip on making roast garlic, and what I'm going to do is take 6 cloves of roast garlic that I made and put them in with our 6 potatoes that it took to make this many cubes. Now, they do not have to be roasted, because we're going to cook this and they will get a lot of flavor, but they're starting out a little bit more mellow this way, so it's kind of a neat trick to do if you want to do that. Now, typically when you mash your potatoes, you're going to put some salt and some butter and some milk in there. So what we're going to do is to put some salt. I'm putting 3/4 of a teaspoon. I want to back off from a teaspoon because I don't want to oversalt, and we can always adjust later. You can't take it out, but you can put more in. So 3/4 teaspoon of salt. And now I'm going to put 1/2 stick of butter. So this is 1/4 cup. And that's going right in there to be cooked with the potatoes. And believe it or not, we're putting some milk in there. You know, you season it with milk when you mash them. Why not cook them in milk instead of cooking them in water, which drains out a lot of the flavor? And what we're going to do is have the flavor go into the milk and save the milk. And if we need extra milk at the end, we'll mash that in with our other flavorings. So what I want to do is pour milk until I can just see it at the potatoes. And that butter will melt, and that will lift the level just a little bit. So something about like that. And then I'm going to put a lid on it. So you would benefit by having a lid that you can see through, because you can keep track of that milk level all the time. This goes to a stove. And we'll turn this on to medium heat, and we'll let it come to a boil. When it comes to a boil, then we will lower the heat, and then we'll cook until they are fork tender. That means I should be able to mash them with a fork. You know, we're going to mash the mashed potatoes, so if they're not mashable, then they're not ready. So this will be my test. I'll just keep the fork here. I won't need to check for a while, but we'll bring it to a boil and then reduce the heat and then just let them cook until they're done. These potatoes have cooked about 17 minutes, and you can sort of see what they look like. And I'm going to get this large piece over here and show you how tender it is and how mashable. That means these are ready to come up. And I did take a taste of one of them, and I could tell it needs more salt and definitely more of a butter taste and probably some milk. So what we're going to do is take this off the stove, and we're going to drain it, but save all of that buttery, salty, garlicky milk. And we'll use that along with any other additives that we need. We're ready to mash our potatoes, and you'll see we have our potato cubes, and here is one piece of garlic, one clove, and there's one. There actually are 6 in there, and I'm leaving them in there. I'm just going to mash them in with the rest. So this goes back into the pot where they were cooked. And we have our milk mixture here, which we'll use as needed. And you might have more than this or less. It just depends on what you started with when you were estimating. But I do think we're going to need some butter flavor in here. So I'm putting 2 tablespoons of butter in. And that's changeable if you like more. And I'm going to put 1/2 teaspoon of salt in. I know that we're not salty enough. And then I'm going to start mashing. I've got a potato masher here, and this will be pretty easy to mash, but it will be very solid. So I will just pick this up and use it as I need it. It's actually kind of hot, so I think I'll go ahead and put a little bit to get started with. And then I'll just continue mashing until we have some nice garlic mashed potatoes. Well, I've mashed until our garlic mashed potatoes are ready, and I'll show you what they look like. They look just like this. And I did add 1 tablespoon butter more, and also I got down to the point of shaking salt in just to make it perfect, because I couldn't say it really needed a 1/2 teaspoon or anything like that, just maybe a touch more salt. So it all boils down to you're going to put butter to taste and you're going to put salt to taste. And as far as the milk is concerned, you have to get this at the consistency that you like, and that's about what you want. I had this much milk left over, so there's probably a little flavor in there that I'm losing out on, but we'll get to find out if Remy likes garlic. But we have our little flecks of garlic here and there, and it's an unusual flavor for mashed potatoes if you haven't had garlic mashed potatoes, but it's interesting. It's more interesting than just plain ones. And you can still have gravy, turkey gravy over it or some other kind. I'm going to put these in a nice serving bowl. And if you get a big spoon like this, they move very easily because they're just the right texture. You have total control over the texture. Now, if you happen to pour too much milk in, then you're stuck with some soggy mashed potatoes. But you're going to watch that as you put the milk in. And you're going to end up with some beautiful garlic mashed potatoes for your Thanksgiving table. Enjoy. I'm going to do one more taste of these, and that's for you. I've got a little tasting spoon here, and I'm just going to dig into the side. Don't want to mess it up too much because these are actually going on the Thanksgiving table. I'll take a bite. And I'll tell you ahead of time, I love mashed potatoes, but I love different flavors of mashed potatoes. If you put cheese in there, or chives, or sour cream, any of those things, I really enjoy. But I thought maybe some of you hadn't tried garlic mashed potatoes, and that's what we would have, and I think they taste delicious, and I think you're going to enjoy them.